friends. You probably saw this video pop up on your feed and you were like, what? Wait, hold on. It's been 4 months since Anna's posted a video. What is this? Well, first of all, I want to explain what happened, how I went from daily vlogging to not vlogging at all. It's not what I wanted to do, but circumstances and whatnot happened and I needed to take a break. My last video that I posted, like I said, was 4 months ago. And if you're new to my channel, I started this a long time ago making dance videos. And when I moved to LA, I started training in dance and along the way ended up taking a different path than I thought that I was going to, which led me here. Which at the end of this video, I'm gonna give you a tour of why the heck I'm in this room and why the sound is so clear. Last year, I started doing vlogs, and most of the reason why is because I wanted to document my experience doing last year's CrossFit Open competition. And for me, it was because I was in between two different skill levels, and I really wanted to push myself and talk about what I was feeling and really connect with people who had the same interests that I did. Once the competition was over, I was trying to figure out what else I wanted to do, and that led into me documenting my experience doing my third round of the Whole30 diet. That intention was so that I could document how I felt every day, how changing my diet affected me from the inside out, and if I could still perform at a higher, but my highest level in CrossFit at the gym. That led us to August. So I was doing the Whole30. I was daily vlogging as much as possible. I put out some really not so good long videos, but what I wanted to get out of it at the end was to learn how to edit videos quickly, create interesting content, something that told the story from start to finish. And I definitely think that I learned that, plus a lot of fun little editing tricks here and there. And then the 18th video came along, and I disappeared at the end of that. I ended that video saying, stay tuned for tomorrow's video. I'm going on another adventure, which I did, and I have footage of. But what ended up happening was a couple of things. The first thing was that my husband came home from training with the Marine Corps for 2 weeks pre-deployment to Japan. So my attention kind of shifted over into family and really enjoying my time with him before he left to the other side of the Pacific. At the same time, within that 2 week period, the Whole30 ended and I dove straight back into eating all of the things that I couldn't have, rather than easing myself back in a little bit at a time, and went from eating really clean to eating whatever the heck I wanted. And I absolutely think that that played into the next part, which was, to be honest, I fell into a pretty intense depression. And if you have experienced that in any way, it's kind of hard to do anything, never mind document your life and feel fully you. And that's something that we can talk about in another video down the road, but that was probably the final straw into me not being able to get back into filming vlogs then. In addition to that, I had a really massive workload change at my actual job, which also plays into what this background is, why it sounds so nice when I don't have any external mics, mind you. So now that we're here and you're sitting here with me and we're having this little conversation, I decided that I really, really wanted to get back into vlogging, but there are a couple of things that I needed to do in my regular everyday life that would then transfer over into the types of videos that I would create for you. Once it became 2019, I created 5 values and wrote them down and realized that these were things that I wanted to incorporate into my life every day very mindfully. The first one was self-awareness, and that means understanding for myself when less is more and when more is more. Jumping into making daily vlogs really taught me a lot, but that workload is unbelievable. So really, really impressed by all of the daily vloggers that are out there that can do this every day for years and years. It's hard. The second thing is confidence, and I'm sure that most of you would be able to relate that sometimes it's hard to keep your confidence level up when you know that there are eyes watching you. And I have this bad habit, and I think it's from all of the years of dance, where I sometimes tend to focus on the negatives versus the really amazing positives that come out of whatever I'm doing. And I don't want to fall back into that. And I don't want to feel like what I'm making isn't good enough, where there's a difference between imposter syndrome and just learning by doing. I'm not expecting every video that I make to be perfect. I'm learning as I go. And first of all, thank you for sticking with me through these videos if you're watching, and watching the bad ones and hopefully sticking with me as I learn to make them better and better and better. The third is quality. And I think that most of you have heard quality over quantity. And now that I have a little bit more experience making vlogs, I want each one that I make to have more intention and quality to it. So rather than feeling forced to make something every day, I want to share with you the things that I really care about, and rather than just making something to make something. You know what I mean? So I'm not just trying to post something to post because I feel like I have a deadline to do it. I just want to make stuff. My battery's about to die. Great. Hold on, I'm gonna go get my other battery. Okay, and before I run out of complete battery, because I am not prepared and I forget how this shit works, the last two things of my values that I want to incorporate into everything that I do is care and kindness towards myself and others. And not that I didn't incorporate that before, but I need to make sure that I'm including myself in that, that I'm taking the time for me and caring about me, because before I can give to anybody else, I have to make sure that my cup is full so that I can do that for others. So that brings us to this. Where the heck am I? I am in one of the vocal rooms for the new dance studio that I helped create, called EXPG LA. It is in the heart of Hollywood and is an artist development school. So we'll have dance classes, vocal classes, acting classes, and the campus, we'll call it, is absolutely state-of-the-art, beautiful, everything. So I'm gonna give you a tour. Let's go. So let's start in here. This is one of the vocal rooms that will be used for vocal lessons, and we're in an entire separate building to dance, which is over there. And that's my realm. This is a little easier to see during the daytime, and it looks a little bit nicer then, but this is a full mural by Futura and Stash. This is one side of the dance studio space. This is where everybody who comes to dance will experience what it's like to learn from their favorite choreographers. So, let me find some light. So in this room, there's spotlights, which is why this lighting is a little crazy. You can see them all on the floor there. Sprung floor, one of the most gigantic sound systems that I've ever seen. There are four speakers, two subs in each side, and this wall right here will tuck away along these tracks into this corner over here and open up into one giant studio. The sound is insane, the feeling in here is insane, and it's everything that I could wish that a studio would feel like. So my position here is to help create the environment that the students are gonna experience when they first walk in the door. So my responsibility was to make sure that when the student comes in the door, it's seamless. It's step one, step two, step three, step four, to make sure that everything is done as well as possible. Customer service, setting up your account, paying for class, getting you in the studio, and then once you're in the studio, the teacher takes over. All of the other stuff behind the scenes, logistics and whatnot, that is me and the team. All of that experience from my other studio, which if you've watched any of my other vlogs, you'll know Movement Lifestyle. All of my experience in the last 6 years kind of culminated into this, which was essentially building the studio infrastructure as just from scratch, making sure that the point of sale system, the scheduling system, all of the information that needs to be in there is set and good to go. So yeah, that's where I've been. That's what I've been up to. And I hope that I will see you in the next video. And if not, thanks for sticking through all this way. And if you've been waiting for this video, I appreciate your patience. I really, really, really do. And I will definitely catch you very soon. Okay, bye. I forgot one very important thing. Japanese toilets. Yep.